Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're gonna see the tricks to easily draw the iron and iron carbide phase diagram. First, we must know the four basic reactions we used to often come across in the phase diagram, that is the eutectic, peritectic, eutectide and peritectoid reactions. Eutectic reaction is where liquid phase on cooling gives two solids. Similarly, other reactions follows. So, how to remember this, where eutectic is liquid to solid and solid to, and peritectic is solid and liquid gives solid. So, what's the trick is that whenever OID comes, all three in the reaction will be solid. That is, in eutectoid, all three, that is reactants and products are all solid. No liquid comes. Similarly, in peritectoid, all three are solid, both reactants and products. So, whenever OID comes, all three in the reaction will be solid. Then, if UU and PR, that is eutectoid, eutectic, and BER, peritectoid, peritectic, the products after reaction will be 2 for eutectoid, eutectic, and peritectoid, peritectic, the products will be 1. You can see that in eutectic, the products is 1, that is liquid gives 2 solids, 1 solid 1, solid 2. Similarly, for peritectic, solid and liquid gives solid, that is whenever EU comes, the products will be 2 products, and whenever PER comes, the products is 1. So, how to remember is that, remember EU as eukaryotes. That is, eukaryotes are multicellular organisms, multi, so the products will be 2. Similarly, PER, remember PER as prokaryotes. Prokaryotes are unicellular, so the products will be 1. So, we can easily remember these 4 basic reactions. Then, to draw the phase diagram, we must know these basic points, that is, alpha ferrite, arsenate, beta ferrite. It is pretty much easier. You can easily remember this. Then we have to remember these basic temperatures, that is 727, 1148, 4045. These temperatures represents the eutectoid, eutectic and peritectoid points. So it is must to remember these temperatures. So what's the trick in remembering this temperature is that we can easily remember 727 degrees Celsius because we used to come across often in the lessons. The 727 degrees Celsius is easier to remember. Then what about 1148 and 1495? What I have a trick is that this 1148 represents the LDH, that is the position of the alphabets in the alphabetic series in ascending order. That is, L is in the 11th place, 11th order of the alphabet series. Similarly, D and H comes under 4 and 8. So, therefore, 1148, it is, point is, for 1148, it is LDH, and similarly for 1495, it is NIE. That is N14, I9, E is 5. So, we can see we used to know that LDH is cholesterol. That good cholesterol, bad cholesterol, we come across in blood test reports. So, cholesterol, remembers cholesterol, just remembers cholesterol. Then, Nahi as Nahi. So, cholesterol Nahi. Okay. Then, 1538. It is, we have to remember because it is the melting point of the pure iron. So, if you come across 2 to 3 times, you can easily remember this. Then, 912 degrees Celsius. These are the basic things to remember to draw the phase diagram. Then, and also, we must know the carbon content. That is 0.77%, 2.11%, 4.3% and 0.18%. And we can remember 0.77 easier because it lies on the 727 degrees Celsius line, that is eutectoid temperature line. So, eutectoid temperature, 2 sevens are there. So, 0.77%. Similarly, 2.11% comes in the 1148 eutectic point temperature line, eutectic point temperature line, and we can see that 211 comes. So 2.11, 211. Then 4.3% is the austenite line. Then 0.18%. So we have to remember these three things, that is alpha pyrite, austenite, beta pyrite, then temperature of the reactions and percentage carbon content. Then step 1, let's proceed with the step 1. First draw the graph, that is with the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis percentage of carbon and y-axis as temperature in degree Celsius. Then draw the four temperature lines we saw before earlier, that is 727, 1148, 1495. That is, this is the temperature line. Temperature, then it's a percentage of carbon. Then these are the reaction temperature lines. That is, it's a eutectoid, it is a eutectic, then it's a peristaltic reaction temperature line. Then we mark the percentage of carbon as we seen earlier. It is 0.77, 211, 4.2 and 0.18. That is 0.77 on 727 degree line, 211 on 1148, 4.3, then 0.18. Then draw the curves of alpha ferrite, austenite and gamma ion and Fe3C. It is easier, as we can see that the structure of that is the size of the alpha and ferrite ion curves are similar, whereas the curve of austenite is big compared to these two. Why? Because austenite curve, as it has high solid solubility because of its FCC crystal structure. That is, compared to this alpha and gamma, the solid solubility of austenite is big, so it has a big curve. That is, it extends till the carbon content of 2.111% compared to this point and this point. So then join the curves, then and mark alpha ferrite, austenite, then gamma ferrite. Then mark and join the eutectoid, peritictic and eutectic points. Then I just draw the curves from 9 just join the curves, eutectoid point, eutectic and peritictic. Then mark the liquid phase, solid phase and this solid phase. The area above this line is in liquid phase because of high temperature. So that's all. So you have seen today that how you can easily draw and remember the iron and iron carbide diagram. Thank you.